Hi, welcome to this video tutorial where we'll be discussing the process of how to enter doctor details in the Catex health system. We'll be discussing every section in detail. So let's start. The first and foremost step is please enter the website of catexhealth.com in the address bar. That is catexhealth.com. Once the website is open, you'll be able to see a login button on the top right corner. Please click the login button. And now you'll be asked to enter the credentials, that is the user ID and the password. Please note that the user ID and password have been sent to you through email and an SMS. So please check and enter the 4-digit or 5-digit user ID to proceed. In the usual scenario, the password is generally the first name of the doctor followed by 123. For instance, the doctor's name is Dr. Arun Gupta, then his password becomes Arun123, where A is in capital. So let's proceed further. So I have my user ID and now I have my password. I have entered the user ID in the user ID field and I have entered the password in the password field. Once the auto-generated password has been sent to you and once you log in to our system, you have the freedom and liberty to change the password. Now I'll click login. As soon as I press login, I will be redirected to my main dashboard homepage of Doctor. Now I can see different sections that are present here. Let's go one by one. In this video tutorial, we are talking about the process of entering doctor details. So our required section is profile, which you can see right here. Please click on this. Once you click on this profile, you see a lot of sections that are present here: personal details, contact details, professional details, etc., etc. Let us go one by one. So in this section, that is personal details, we have basically the name, gender, address, and the date of birth of the doctor. If you can see here, there are some red asterisks which have been marked right besides the required or mandatory fields. These fields are mandatory and cannot be left empty at any point in time. So I have entered the first name as Test. I have entered the last name as Dr. Amin. Date of birth is not mandatory, but it's a good to have. Similarly is gender. Similarly is address. Country is mandatory, city is mandatory, state is mandatory, and PIN code is mandatory. If you have your own website, please feel free to mention the URL of the website. Once you have added all the details and checked if the added details are correct, just scroll down to the page and click save and next. Once you click save and next, you will be automatically redirected to this section, which is called contact details. In this section, it basically talks about the email ID, the mobile number, and the hospital or the clinic address. I've mentioned the email ID. I've mentioned my primary mobile number. If you have a secondary mobile number, please mention that. Please mention the hospital or the clinic name. Again, the address is mandatory for the hospital or the clinic. We add the country as India. We add the state. We add the city. We add the PIN code. And if you have a clinic phone number that you want to add, or if you have an hospital phone number that you want to add, please mention here. If in case there are multiple clinics that are associated that you are associated with, please click add more and multiple fields will open. So if suppose you are associated with two clinics and one hospital, you can further add more fields. So there's no limit to adding fields in this section. Okay. Now, once we have checked, once we have verified if everything is correct, We click save and next. Now this section is actually professional details. Professional details is nothing but a section that talks about educational qualifications, degrees and specialties. So under the speciality section, I will write general surgery, or whatever your speciality is, you can mention it here. Once I click MBBS in the degree section, I will have to click add more to insert more degrees. So for instance, I'm a MBBS and an MD. I will just write MD, the initials, and I'll do this. So if you can see here, now both my degrees have been added in the system. If there are multiple degrees, please feel free to add them and click add more. Under the speciality section, I've mentioned general surgery or whatever the speciality for your specific domain is, please enter that and click add more. Based on the domicile, please do enter the registration number of your specific council or body. After filling in the degrees and the registration number, I would like to reiterate, if there are multiple specialties associated with you, please add as many as possible in the section below. So if my speciality is general surgery and in addition to that I have to add more specialties, I can add more specialties, and please add more. Once you click add more, the specific speciality gets saved. Now, if you look at the bottom of the page, there's a save and next button. If you click save and next button, automatically it will redirect you to the next section. Now this section is actually video consultation, but this section also talks about your OPD timings. So if suppose I have to set my OPD timings, I have three sections here, as you can see. One is the from time, the other is the to time, and the third is the time slot duration. Let's go one by one. From time is nothing but the start time of that specific day. To time is nothing but the end time for that specific day. And time slot duration is the duration of time that you will be devoting for the specific appointment or consultation. So for instance, I have my appointments from Monday, Wednesday and Friday, alternate days, and the appointments start at 9 a.m. in the morning and they go till 6 p.m. in the evening, right? And the time slot duration is all denoted in minutes. So let me just choose 15 minutes, right? Now this is one time slot that I follow for Monday, Wednesday and Friday, right? In many scenarios, it is possible that on Tuesdays, Thursdays and Saturdays, the time slots would be different and the timings could also be different. So what I'll do is, I will click add more, right? And now for Tuesdays, Thursdays and Saturdays, I have my time from 10 a.m. to 7 p.m. and I'll keep the time slot duration as 15 only, right? You can play around as per your convenience, as per your availability, based on whatever suits you. Once you've done this, click save and next. And now we need to check whether the time slots that we have entered are correct or not. So on Monday, Wednesday and Friday, I have entered the time slot from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. And on Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, I have entered it from 10 a.m. to 7 p.m. there could be various combinations, there could be various different days and different time slot combinations which you can play around. Every time you'll have to create a new combination and press add more and save and next. This section is primarily for those doctors who are taking video consultations. There are patients who will be paying the doctor via the digital medium. Once all the mandatory fields have been entered in the bank details section, like name of account, account number, IFSC code, bank name, type of account, and PAN number, please recheck if all the data fields that have been entered are correct. If not, please edit and modify. And once you've done that, please click save and next. Right now, I have not entered anything. That's why it is not moving ahead. We come to the next section, which is upload documents. In this section, there are a couple of data fields which need to be uploaded, where images in JPEG, GIF, or PNG format can be uploaded. Let's go one by one. So if you see here, PAN card, your photo, the MCI registration number, the degree, and signature. These are some mandatory fields which need to be updated. It's very simple. For every field, there's a button called choose file. Click on the choose file and select the respective image. If you see here, while I was uploading the signature that will be further used for prescription, the image which I uploaded is a bigger image. So the system will allow me to crop the image in such a manner that so after attaching all these documents, there is a possibility that there are some additional degrees or certificates that you want to upload. So I will do choose file and I will just click on this specific certificate and I will change the document type to certificate. You can add multiple certificates and degrees. If you have multiple certificates or degrees, please click the upload more button. And it will allow you to upload more. Once all the fields are updated, please click save and next. Now we'll be talking about a section called configure prescription. So if you want to do video consultation, then you need to configure your prescription. And to configure the prescription, we need to fill a couple of fields. Let's go one by one. So the first is the name. The complete name of the doctor should be mentioned here. If this field, which is the degree field, if this is empty, please mention the respective degrees. Please add the address. Please add the registration number. So these fields are mandatory because they'll be reflected on the prescription. We'll come to that. Now we have a logo. Please choose the logo. Since this is a oversized image, the system gives you the option of cropping and resizing it. So once I've entered all the fields, on the bottom right section, we have three buttons called preview, save, and cancel. So what we need to do is we need to press the save button in order to save all the fields which we had updated. Once the logo and the registration number, address, degree and the doctor name has been saved, we get a notification in the header section stating record has been saved. In order to view the prescription form, we will now click the preview button. So if you see the header of the prescription, we have the logo, we have the doctor's name, we have the doctor's degrees, we have the address, which is the clinic address or the hospital address, and we have the registration number of the specific body or the council. In the footer section, we have the date and we have the signature of the doctor. Now coming to the second part of configuring prescription. Now if you see here, there are a couple of radio buttons that are present under the body content section. We need to check all these radio buttons to yes and select all the vitals that are present here so that these fields, when filled by the doctor at any point in time, are automatically represented in the prescription. Once we have checked all the radio buttons to yes and the vitals are also ticked, on the bottom right section we have a save button. We click the save button and our prescription is now ready. So this tutorial comes to an end. In this tutorial, we have learnt how to enter personal details, how to enter contact details, how to enter professional details, how to enter different time slots for video consultation and OPD, how to enter the bank details, how to upload the different documents that are required for prescription and otherwise, how to configure the specific prescription. With this, we come to the end of the tutorial. Thank you.